everybody, welcome to the Whale Zone series. My name is Milou, I'm a marine biologist and guide in Terra Azul. And in this series, we are answering all your questions about whales, dolphins, and marine life. In this episode, I will answer the question, what are microplastics? And be sure you watch until the end of the video where I'm going to give you some useful tips about how you can help to preserve the ocean and its wildlife. Be sure to check the links in the description and comment below. Plastic waste comes in many different sizes, and particles less than 5 millimeters in size are called microplastics. So now about the sources. Where is all that microplastic coming from? One of the main sources is fibers from clothes. It is estimated that one wash of clothes can release up to 700,000 synthetic fibers. And it is even found in tap water recently. Another very common source is microbeads in exfoliants, toothpaste, and in other beauty products, and even in cigarette butts. Also accidental loss of industrial materials like plastic pallets and abrasion of car tires contribute to this scenario. So it is not a surprise that microplastics are the biggest problem in very dense populated areas around the world. But even in already 18 sites over 6 continents, microplastic is found all the way from the shore to the beach to the deep sea and the wide ocean. Recent studies also suggest that krill is able to digest microplastics, but this is not a solution to the problem because they are very likely to just turn them into nanoplastics, which are even smaller butts. Microplastics are harmful from the low food chain up to us humans. So remember, when you are eating seafood, you are potentially ingesting those microplastics yourself. Persistent organic pollutants remain in the environment, which is even worse because they biomagnify and bioaccumulate, making their harmful effects even worse as they stay in the food chain. This means that they do not only accumulate, but also increase their concentration inside of the animal tissue. Therefore, it is difficult to assess the actual extent of the microplastics to the environment and to us, making it even more concerning what it is actually doing to the environment. Subscribe to be updated about the newest videos on whales, dolphins, and marine life. And if you want us to answer your questions, please remember to check the links below and comment on the video. It is very likely that plastic waste in the ocean will continue to grow due to failing of reusing, recycling, and waste management in many parts of the world, and due to an increase of consuming plastic. So here are a few very easy tips how you can help to reduce plastic. First, try to use as many natural fiber clothes as you can. Second, don't use exfoliants that contain microbeads, but instead look for exfoliants that have beans or sand instead. Third, don't throw your cigarette butts on the floor, but put them in the trash. Fourth, don't use your car as much as you do now, and check the status of your tires to be sure they are not releasing any particles due to aging. Thank you very much. See you next week. Bye.